Now, allocating and transferring memory is pretty straightforward. The interesting part of GPU computing is defining the computation that actually happens on the GPU. We structure that computation as a series of one or more kernels. Now, as we said earlier, the GPU has lots of parallel computation units. So when you write kernels, those kernels need to take advantage of that hardware parallelism. So how do they do that? And here is the big idea. It is one of the very core concepts of CUDA. As a programmer, when you write a kernel, you write what looks like a serial program. You write this program as if it runs on a single thread. Then when you call the kernel from the CPU, you tell it how many threads to launch, and each of those threads will run this kernel. It is perfectly okay to write a kernel and then tell the GPU, okay, when you start running this kernel, launch 100,000, launch 1,000,000, launch 10 million threads, each of which will run this kernel code. You can and will kick off an enormous amount of computation each time you launch a kernel. Now, we haven't covered this yet, but you might be able to make a good guess. Given this programming model, what is the GPU good at? Check all that apply. Launching a small number of threads efficiently, launching a large number of threads efficiently, running one thread very quickly, running one thread that does lots of work in parallel, or running a large number of threads in parallel.